Okay, friends, subscribers, and all you YouTubers out there, just an update. Yeah, the set's going along. Yeah, sort of. Managed to get some of the components to the set. Only problem is I don't know if I'm going to have time to actually get it together now. But I will show you the progression of the movie set whilst we're doing it, because this movie set is part of the Mandela Effect movie Ripped Away. It has to be. So what I'm doing is I'm going to film a little bit of basic footage for it. Sort of like in a third person cam, as if the is discovering the loss and he's trying to record what has happened to the set. And when I get it built, I'll say, oh yeah, look at this, and then it'll be a chop and change, it'll go reverse order sort of thing. So I'm doing my best and everything to get it up and running. I've got to get the monitor stand built for the other side of the table, which is what I've been doing today, but again, out of stuff. So I've got to nick over the hardware first thing in the morning and grab some nuts. Yeah, I've become a bit of a nut myself the last 24 hours, trying to bloody do all this and get it all done and do a major spring clean at the same time. Now, reason why I'm actually doing this video, everybody, is a few people have been asking me in the comments and messaging me pretty much, why am I deliberately staying in a verse that's not my own? Why? Because I found out I've got a pretty major neck injury and I've got to find out what it is. And plus, it's a bit of a holiday as well. I'm not jumping all the time and so... But I need to find out how bad this injury actually is. I won't know that until Monday, so hence I'm going to do the Halloween show. But I've also decided at least to get this part of the movie set built. As I said, this is the one verse that's so far behind with the movie set, it's beyond a joke. And I've decided to put a bit of time, seems I've got to find out what's going on with my neck. And I have decided that if there is something wrong with my neck, i.e. that needs surgery, that I will be having the surgery here in this reality. They seem to have a pretty good medical thing here. So if I need the surgery, I'll make sure it's done here, even if I'm here for a couple of months. I will use that magnet to keep me in this verse so I can have the surgery, because I don't want to go to another verse and then have to go through all the crap of seeing doctors and stuff like that. I know I had the injury. So yeah, I am a bit worried about it, so I pretty much want to find out what extent the injury is. And as I said, I'll know that tomorrow, on Monday. And if it's pretty much doesn't require surgery and stuff like that, I'll finish the set and then I'll stop using the magnets. And yeah, I will deliberately stop using the magnets. That way, eventually I'll get to go home. Maybe with what we've been doing might even spur them to let us go home. And but the whole thing is, it's sort of, I've just wanted to answer those questions and everything, because I thought it was pretty relevant to why I'm actually deliberately staying here. And that is mainly because, like, I went to a medical appointment for the other beard only to find out that he sent me, wanted me to have a secondary x-ray just to double check, and because he was getting conflicting results with x-rays, and we all know why, because they were different beards. And when he sent me in, lo and behold, he found out I had a major neck injury for some unknown reason, and I'm still trying to work out how in the hell it happened. Most probably when the bastards dropped me on the bed every time. But so I'm sort of just putting this video out just to let you guys know I don't have time to do a live stream, and I just wanted to sort of keep you all updated. And Yeah, I don't know what's going on with this damn video. It sort of just driving me nuts at the moment. And I've been having a few time events here as well, which have been freaky. Time slowed down 3 times today and then sped up. Just did it again, actually. You can't see what I'm seeing, but it was on the timer of the recording. And 1 minute it's like slowed all the way down to 4 minutes and was hardly moving. Then all of a sudden it just sped up something shocking. I've been doing that for about 10 hours today. The whole point of it, of staying here, is to make sure that I'm healthy. And I think any of the beards would do the same, and I think any of you would do the same. Considering I've been jumping the verse every 2 weeks pretty much, and the MRI turned the implant off, and hence they've been taking me every day, every night without fail. Let's just say I'm waiting for them, so I'm about to go to bed and I'm waiting for them to come. I've just done my journal entry, and so I've hit myself with a magnet, and I'm doing it night and day at the moment. Just to be safe, and because I know whenever the magnetic field definitely turns those implants off, and I'm talking big, strong, bloody fields. And what I'll do, I'll show you, is a thumper tomorrow too, which is equivalent to what I've got, but doesn't have the same effect, even though the Gauss is the same. It just doesn't have the same effect on the thing. You can't feel the implant heating up, where with the 3000 Gauss trapezoids, yeah, they do heat up. And so I just thought I'd better let you know what's going on. And I do still have been updating the farewell video, guys and girls, just in case they do manage to take us through whatever they're doing to us. And I'm also wondering if my neck injury is the reason that I haven't jumped. That is also a great possibility. A lot of the, as I said in a couple of videos ago, that I was fearful that this is some kind of medical verse or whatever. Are we in that prison city, on that prison planet? There is still that great possibility. That is a possibility. So we've got to look at all options, guys and girls, and because it's scary as all fuck, it really is. But, yeah, as to Halloween, right, it's going to have to happen in the one room because of the fact that the components didn't turn up, I didn't get to set the other room up, and so it's just a matter of just rigging everything and running everything. And so I'm trying to do my absolute best to get everything set up for it. And I've managed to do everything, and I've got the set ready. I'm gonna unbox the Vibe before the show, so it's up and running. And pretty much I'll just put that out as a video. It won't be as a live stream unbox on the new channel. And there is a great possibility that my friend is actually going to turn up. He came down today and everything, and he wanted to know a bit more info about it. And he wants to know if he can improv, and I said, yeah, mate, you can improv, because as I said to everybody, Halloween is going to be a fun night, okay? And I'm dedicating it to a fun night. And I'm going to be, let's just say, I'm going to be making fun of our little green fucking friends. And so that, as I said, I'm going to make fun of it. And because if we don't make fun of it and can't laugh, then we're pretty much just screwed, I'd say. So I'm trying to do my best and trying to keep everything up and going, and everything. And as I said, like, I do want to finish the set because, like, I came from a set that was just absolutely fucking incredible, and I want to try and duplicate that here before I go. That is going to be the thing. But if I do get taken prior, that there are enough drawings for the next version to take it from there and go and build it. And hopefully he is as dedicated as I have been. And I've done a couple of little pieces of furniture that I'll show you and everything. And and by the way, all the beers can make furniture. It's something I've noticed all throughout the verse, that every single one of us has been making furniture, but none of them. I'm the only one that seems to be making it to sell it, and because that's how I've been surviving. And all the verses is I've been making furniture, because I'm only generally there for a couple of weeks, so I'll do a couple of jobs, might make one piece of furniture, and because I can knock a piece out in a couple of days, so if I need cash, and there's always timber, and get out in a table saw and do a bit of work. We get out the bandsaw, the drill, knock it together, and let's just say a little festool, it's not really a biscuit cutter. They're called domino cutters, and they're fucking unreal, dead set. The domino cutter is a fucking brilliant little tool, and makes you can make furniture so bloody quick, it's beyond a joke. So I haven't stained these ones and everything. If I get time, I'm going to stain them before I go. And so those of you that want to see what I've been doing to survive while I've been here, I'll put that out tomorrow if I've got time. If I don't have time to do a live stream, everybody, you've got to forgive me, but I am doing my best. And because I do have the set to build and everything like that, and I've got to get the green screens up, and there's a lot of work involved, and I'm trying to concentrate on that. So this video is not going to be too long, but hopefully Rob does come down, because he is honestly a crazy bastard, dead set. He really is. He's fun to be around, and he's been the same in every verse. And I'll tell you now, he's definitely affected. He is 100% affected. Like today, he noticed that when I first got here was the hall. That the hall had been painted in the last one. It sort of was pretty much, sort of thing. And it's happened too quick to do it. And so he's starting to notice the stuff. So I think he is actually affected. I'm starting to notice a lot of people see things and stuff like that. It's really, really weird on what people are noticing, when they're noticing it. And you hear a lot when you're out in public, you'll sort of see people looking at something, and you know that they will say no, and you hear them going, no, that's not right, because they know that something's wrong. I think a lot more people are starting to wake up. I really, truly do. So those of you out there that don't know what's going on. Now, with the channel, I haven't actually promoted the new channel, and that other channel is not the channel I've been talking about. That is an idea from one of the other Bluebeards, and pretty much I'm continuing on with it. And I'd say the others will definitely continue on with it. So it's just something else that you'll all eventually find out. But now, as to that little thing that we were going to release, it's not going to be released straight away. We've got something we've got to sort out, which is legal, which I didn't know about. And I've got to finalise something before I can actually go public about it. It's patent stuff that you've got to do, and the other beards, and I've made the other beards aware of it as well. So these hiccups happen with inventions and stuff like that. But I'm going to talk about the craft, I'm going to play games and do what I can to have some fun on All Hallows Eve, because I'm working my ass off here, and let's just say I'm going to deserve to have some fun, and introduce Rob to radio shows and internet shows so that he can think about joining me on the new channel, and i.e. that's what the new channel is for. But until I get a definite and we've got stuff sorted out, that one's under wraps until such time we're ready to launch it. And it might take some time, but we're not going to launch that until such time we have ample subscribers. And I'm not joking, it's not being launched until there's ample subscribers. And there's a reason for it and everything like that. There's been some teaser stuff going out and everything. So, you can go along and watch it. And the teaser stuff doesn't happen all the time. And it just happens randomly and stuff like that. Because I noticed there's one person, I don't know whether it's government or whatever, but there's one person constantly watching that channel. There's always just that one. So we've been having some fun. And so hopefully Rob will look into doing it, and then maybe we'll launch that one too. But we've got some stuff to do and everything like that. We've got some new stuff to show you as well. And if I can get it to bloody work, it's not going to work. It doesn't work when I've got this thing going. It's going to drive me nuts at the moment. Yep, not working. And I sincerely apologise for that, everybody. Somehow we got a little bit of feedback. Big time feedback, actually. So, it's just some weird shit going on, and I just don't know what's actually happening, and there's been a lot of weird stuff going on today, and everything with this computer. I'm sure we've got a bug in it, and I've been trying to resolve that bug as well. And one thing I wanted to show you was, where is it, if I can find it, it will come up on the screen. We've got some other stuff, like that one. Don't know if you can hear that. And we got this one. And we'll play that one too. And give myself some fanfare. And I'll even give myself some applause. Hopefully that worked. I don't know. I'll have to have a look which was. So those of you out there that just heard all that sort of stuff, I was just having some fun. But it makes you wonder what's going on, and because so many people out there are sheep. You never know what's going on, when it's going on. No one knows anymore. I think we've all been trying to work out what is happening and why it's happening, when it's happening. No one freaking knows. And it's a bit of a nightmare. We all know that. We definitely all know that. That sometimes stuff just happens and you never ever know, but so many people out there are sheep. They truly are sheep, and they're just following along with everybody else, and they don't know. They really don't know what in the hell is going on. And to stop it and fix it is just themselves are the only ones that can do it. And because, like, I'm getting it every day where people are saying, oh, well, this is different, but it can't be that thing that everybody's talking about. But the Mandela effect is real. No matter what anybody says, it's fucking real. There's too many of us out there that are suffering from it. Too many of us that are being transported around the frigging galaxy. And, like, we are not of this earth. No matter what anybody says, we don't belong here. The affected do not belong on this fucking planet. This is not our home world. All we want to do is fucking go home. So, that's enough for me. I just want to, say hi, bye, and I'll see you on All Hallows Eve, 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, Australian Time, will be the first show. The second show will be advertised once we jump over to the gaming channel. I will schedule a new show, and I will be scheduling a few shows over those few days. All Hallows Eve is going to be about, some fun. Because I think we all need to have a little bit of fun. And because we've all been stressed out from what has been happening to us. And I think we deserve to have a little bit of fun, guys and girls. And I'll catch you on All Hallows Eve, guys. All right, bye.